I was always wondering about studios, these spaces that you can just close yourself in and you can just play around with instruments, with machines, and you have way more time than you have instead of live sound. The sound engineer I learned from, called Carlo, back in Brescia, he told me, he suggested, said, well, you should have a look at Berlin or London. And yeah, you know, a month later I was here. On my own. My name is Marta Salogni, and I'm a recording engineer, producer, mixer. When I was still in Italy, I was going to high school. I started to go to these sort of reclaimed space in my hometown, Brescia. There was a bunch of equipment because there was a venue on the back of these this space, and I was fascinated by this. It was really big mixers, a Yamaha. Nothing special, but big and many faders, and I was wondering what does these do. Big PA, so I got introduced to the sound engineer. I wanted to learn more about it, and he was really kind, and he started to teach me a few things, and I will learn day by day. You know, I would go to school, and then after school, I would go to this venue and help him set up. Because I was too young to have a car, and when I went to school, it was 30 miles away from where I was living. I never got to see a concert that I set up for until I was 18 and studying myself. How I approach the feature and choosing the tracks is quite interesting, because it's like diving into your musical history, you know, your soundtracks of different moments of your life. And I wanted to try and pick both new and old influences, ones that which were formative and one which were more inspiring on a later date for different reasons. The first track that suddenly came to mind was Love Without Sound by White Noise. For me, that track is a convergence of so many elements that I love. It's a convergence of radiophonic workshop, the tape works. This, I don't know, it transcends times and genres in a way that, like, it feels so modern. And this party was done such a long time ago. It holds within itself a world that is, like, sonically is so coherent and perfect. And it just transports you very heavily in another state. And it's quite rare for me to be able to experience that. It's a song that I listen, I think, once a week at least, one time. Another track that I've picked is Se Telefonando by Mina. This is because it's a track which I've listened to since I'm a child. Everyone knows it, you know, in Italy. If you go down the street and if you walk down the street, you start singing it. It's basically a story of trying to say goodbye to your love, but knowing that by seeing them again, you will suffer, so you're trying not to. And she goes through the story by singing each line higher and higher in pitch, when it just reaches this, for the climax, reaches this like zenith, and you think that she can't go any higher, but she does. And you just feel like, I feel like I'm holding my breath all the time when I listen to it. And it just always surprised me, and every time I try and sing with her and I just drop out because it's impossible. Here we are, stuck by this river. Another track I choose is By This River by Brian Eno, and it's a track that I discovered not long ago. I love the, I can't call it simplicity because it's so intricate in itself, but yet the feeling that I get from it is this purity in a way of emotions. At the end of it,
you feel better
in a way. Yeah, it's become very precious. Another track I picked is If I Should Die by Sonic Boom. It's quite funny how I came across it. Someone showed me a record that I quite liked, and I was trying to find it again, and instead of finding that record, I found this track. I can lose myself in it, and for a second, you know, nothing else happens around, which is beautiful. It's like a sense of abandon, but a really beautiful one. Just feeling good, you know. It does have that enormous meaning for me. Hands in the Dark. I picked this label because I came across them by working on a track that came out on this label, and I just fell in love with it. They all sound brilliant. When I encountered this label, I just felt understood, you know, as in my needs, as a listener, and maybe a little bit also as someone that works in music and always wants something which is quite maybe other, if you want to call it like that. When I listen to something, I want to be able to go like, how did I do that? Rather than being like, oh, I know what's behind. When I listen to tracks put out by them, I'm fascinated, and it just makes me want to make music. Yeah, that's why I picked the label, which is, a great one. When did I start to love tapes? I don't know. They're more than machines for me. Might be the movement that makes them a bit more human. Might be the fact that they're very temperamental, like humans. And the fact that you can record sounds magnetically onto tape, that's crazy and beautiful. I usually perform only with tapes, so I would bring three of them. And then be me reciting a poem, yes. Each poem coincides with a performance. I never repeat a piece twice. So I compose a piece and I plan a piece for one night. And then I either disintegrate the loops so they can't be played twice. And for the next one, I come up with a different concept, a different idea, a different poem. And I do it all again. Yeah, I don't want to repeat anything. And it's a live performance and it will remain like that. As long as I'm doing it.